In part one of the non-photorealistic rendering tutorial, we looked at the ability of Krakatoa to produce custom Lambert shading and cartoon shading using gradients in the global channel overrides to control the emission color based on the angle of the normals in view space. A logical variation to this approach would be to remove the paint completely and keep only the outline. We can switch the color to a vector with a value of white, switch the ink to black, and also replace the background with white in order to produce the same color inside and outside. If we would render now, we will get only the ink as a black outline on white paper. Of course, we can control the thickness by changing the gradient. And in order to get a slightly less random result in the particle distribution, we can uncheck the jitter position in the PRT volume. This will produce slightly cleaner lines. Another approach to control the ink on the outside of the shape of the object being rendered would be to use the motion blur and produce a custom velocity channel which causes multiple versions of the same outline to be drawn on top of each other based on a custom velocity vector. Let's create a new Krakatoa channels modifier in the same global override, set the output to velocity, the input to a vector value with the value 0, 0, -1. This is the camera view vector looking into the image. We're going to transform this value, which is currently in view space, from view space. This will produce a vector in world space, and we're going to create the cross product with the normal of each particle. Then we'll normalize the result and multiply by a float, which will define the length of the velocity vector. Let's enable the motion blur, change the number of samples to 8, and check the jittered motion blur. Now we're drawing 8 passes of motion blur, and we could compare using the presets and history rollout to the previous rendering . You'll see that there is a certain amount of smoothness added to the final rendering thanks to the multiple passes on top of each other . Now let's try to increase the multiplier used in the Krakatoa channels modifier. Let's use a value of 1000 and try to draw the same particles with a much longer velocity vector. This starts producing a more artistic result, where multiple strokes are being used to define the outline of the object. Right now we are using jittered motion blur. We can disable it and try to render the same particles without the jittering. That means that 8 samples will be drawn without randomizing the positions of the samples, and this will give us an obvious set of 8 strokes along each line. Currently, the Krakatoa channels modifier defines a vector which is perpendicular to both the camera view axis and the normal, and thus is tangential to the outline of the object. We can, of course, also change the shutter of the motion blur. This will produce even stronger variation in the strokes, and the final result will look even more artistic. Let's switch back to something like 240 and try to generate less randomized look. We could set up a final rendering of an animation of this object rotating at 360 degrees in order to take a look at the object from all directions while being drawn using this pencil approach. Here is the resulting animation of 360 degrees rotation of the bunny. We're going to load the sequence from 0 to 99 because frame 0 and frame 100 have exactly the same orientation, and we want to make the animation loopable. Now let's load all the frames and take a look at the pencil animation.